In this video, I'm going to be going over this website right here called usertesting.com. It's basically a website where you go and test other people's websites or mobile apps, and you get paid to do so. Really quick, how it works is you apply, you get sent a practice test, you complete the practice test, and then you wait a couple days to see if you're approved. Chances are you are going to get approved, unless you're using a fucking empty can of soup with a string attached to it as your microphone. Otherwise, you should be pretty safe. Once you do get approved, this is what your main home screen is going to look like. This is where your tests show up, and it shows you the dollar amounts that you'll receive upon completing these tests. I am going to tell you right now, it is not a guarantee that you are going to be able to do every single test that comes up on the screen. Now, you might hear a lot of people say, oh yeah, user testing is fucking easy money. You can do this as a full-time job. Easy fucking peasy. No, not so fast. I don't have anything up right now for my desktop, but you have to complete screener questions before you can actually take a test. And then if you're lucky enough to complete the screening and get approved to take the test, you have to make sure you take that test well and do a good job at it and not just sit there and bullshit through it. Because if you sit there and lie on the screener questions, you could end up fucking yourself and then you look like a fucking idiot while taking the test, and you actually risk getting booted off of the platform altogether. So yeah, don't be stupid. But yeah, anyway, you have to take quick screenings before each test, and that can consist of 1 to like 12, 14 questions just to get approved to take the test. They're really serious about this shit. And if you answer one question out of all of those questions that are not to their liking, you will automatically get disapproved, and it will say, oh, try again next time, or we still love you, shit like that. So for example, a screener could have 5 questions. The first question is, how many shits do you take in a day? And it'll have the answers like 1, 2, 10, 20. You select 10, but they were looking for 20. Boom, you're automatically disapproved and you have to move on to the next screening. I've been doing this for about 2 weeks now, almost 3 weeks, and I've taken a total of 5 tests, and I can show you right here. This is my completed test list. This is the first one, and this is just a generic thing that they'll send you upon completing the first test. It's not like an actual human sent this shit to me. Right here, I've gotten paid, or I'm about to get paid another $10, but in total, I've made $50 so far. It's nice to do as a little side gig if you have spare time, if you're able to actually get tests, because again, it's pretty hard. I would say expect to do 1 to 2 tests a week if you're lucky. It's not something where you're going to be finding tests left and right willy-nilly and you're going to be fucking making $1,000 in a week and shit like that. No, it's just not going to happen. There are other things that come up on here as well, where it's live recordings. It's like a live interview. They'll pay you $60 to do that as well. I don't ever do those because I don't have a webcam, and for a lot of those, they require a webcam. So I just stick to shit like this that's usually just on the desktop that only requires my voice. And I will say, the mobile app stuff I have had trouble with. The one test that I did get approved for through the mobile app was a fucking nightmare. I went to go and take the test, and it just literally took me to the Google Play Store, and that was it. It was recording my stuff, but that's all it was doing. Was it just showed Google Play Store. It didn't send me to the app that I needed to test or anything like that. It didn't even tell me the app that I needed to download. It literally just took me to the Play Store. So that was a little fucked, and I had to report an error. That was the only time I've ever tried to do it on my smartphone, and I'm a little hesitant to do it again because I worry that it's going to happen again, but I guess we'll see. So I just stick to the desktop ones that are voice recording only. Most tests will take about 5-10 minutes. Sometimes you'll get one that takes you about a half hour. It really depends, but it's really just an easy way to make a quick $5-$10 per test. Some tests will pay $4 if it's a really quick one, but every one of them that I've taken so far has been $10. So it's a side gig, and that's it. It's something for just a little bit of cash on the side. It's nothing that you're going to be able to do like full time all day. I mean, that's just not realistic. And I want to get that thought out of people's heads that you can just fucking do user testing as a full-time gig and make a fuck ton of money from it, because it's just not going to happen. But yeah, that's really about it. I just want to make a quick video showcasing how it works and what it actually is like, rather than seeing people advertise the shit and make it seem like, oh yeah, this is something that you can do for a full-time job and shit like that. I know there's not many people that say that. I just know there's some that will advertise it as such. But yeah, that's really about it.